Welcome at the study Nanotechnology here in Twente. In Nanotechnology, we do not only study theory, but we also focus on practical courses. And there you learn how to make nanostructures and also to characterize them. One of the important courses in Nanotechnology is Nanolab. And in this video, we will elaborate on this practical course. As a student in Nanotechnology, you'll get familiar with different experimental techniques. And this is an example of an instrument where you can make materials on a nanoscale and also characterize the materials on a nanoscale. The Nanolab course consists of three practical courses, all involving 1 week. The practical courses deal with the preparation and characterization of nanostructures. One of these practical courses takes place in the clean room. There the students and researchers use, amongst others, lithography techniques to fabricate nanostructures. Before the students enter the clean room, they are already familiar with most experimental techniques and fabrication methods. This information is provided in a separate course. One of our students has recently completed this practical course and is now going to tell something about her Nanolab experiences.
Hi, my name is Luz. I did my bachelor's degree in chemistry, and during my graduation, I learned about the clean room and its techniques, and I thought it was fascinating, so I wanted to learn more. That's why I decided to pursue a master's degree in nanotechnology. During the master, you get to do a course called Nanolab. This is a really fun course because you enter the clean room 3 times in which you do lithography experiments. And when you're done, you analyze your experiments using scanning electron microscopy. It's really cool to look on the screen and see these very tiny structures that you just made. Another thing we did was X-ray reflectometry, in which we analyzed the thickness of very thin layers. And with very thin, I mean 3 nanometer, 2 nanometer thin. The last thing we did was go to the organic lab to perform 3D digital light processing, a 3D printing technique. Here we did tensile testing and eventually also did atomic force microscopy, in which we could see exactly what we made.
The clean room is part of the well-known MESA Plus Research Institute for Nanotechnology. MESA Plus is the largest nanotechnology institute in the Netherlands with about 500 employees. During the study, nanotechnology students are often involved in the ongoing research activities of the MESA Plus Institute. In the final phase of your study, you will perform your master thesis research in one of the research groups of the University of Twente. As nanotechnology student, most of these projects are executed in the Nanolab. Kai, who is one of the supervisors of these projects, will now share his experience with you.
Here we are in the lab of the Physics of Interfaces in Nanomaterials group. Besides the fabrication part of the course, there is also a characterization part. Within the characterization part, students are introduced into a lab-based environment, and they learn how to work with techniques such as low-energy ion scattering, ellipsometry, and scanning tunneling microscopy. In addition, they learn how to work with different materials, such as polymers, thin films, and graphene. They work in groups of 2 to enhance cooperation, and they do this under the supervision of an experienced researcher. The equipment used is situated within the labs of the groups and are used for daily activities. In this example, students are introduced with a scanning tunneling microscope. Here you can see a tabletop version of the scanning tunneling microscope, but within the pin group, we have several more advanced microscopes. These advanced microscopes are used by the students with the graduation assignment at the end of the curriculum. However, the basic principle of scanning tunneling microscopy is best learned on this tabletop version. During this part of the course, the students will be introduced to the material graphene. In this way, they learn how to do independent research, which means that there is no singular outcome. Each decision they take has influence on the next investigation they will do. In this way, they will ask different questions like, what do I measure? What can I extract from the data? And which data is relevant? These are actually the questions you will ask when you're performing research yourself.
If you want to do hands-on research in an exciting environment, then the course Nanolab of the study Nanotechnology is ideally suited for you.